Hello, this is Stampy Longnose, and welcome back to my Let's Play of the game Ico. If you remember where I left off, I was here feeling quietly confused as to what to do, and since that video I had a little bit of a wander around and tried to work out what I had to do. I completely failed at trying to work out what I had to do. I got incredibly frustrated because I wanted to get the video made, and so I'll be honest, hands up, I swallowed my pride and I resorted to looking at a walkthrough online. And I saw what I had to do, and it seems relatively obvious. It wasn't too obscure of a puzzle. I was so fixated on trying to push another block down here, I didn't think about the fact that if I come here, I shout to my friend Yorda, I can just go and lift her up through the hole, and that's what I'm supposed to do. And it does seem pretty obvious now. That's the annoying thing with walkthroughs. One, you feel like, I don't know about you, I feel kind of dirty about using them. And then, I don't know, it makes you feel stupid. You go for the walkthrough, and if it seems obvious, you feel stupid. And sometimes it makes you feel good. Sometimes you look at it, like, especially on some point-and-click games, like, I don't know, like Monkey Island games and stuff. Sometimes you go on it and you think, like, really? That was the answer? That's so stupid and obscure, like, no wonder I didn't get it. But sometimes like that, it makes you feel stupid in terms of thinking, like, I should have known that. I should have been able to work that out. Anyway, no matter how I decided to work it out and how I managed to proceed, I have proceeded and I'm now in a brand new area. It looks like there's some sort of lift here. Going up. Seems like we're getting closer towards this top of the fortress, and it seemed pretty high anyway, and I'm not even sure what we're trying to do now because they shut the gate on us, and like, I would assume that we'd have stayed around the gate and tried to work out a way over it or something, but we seem to have just completely ignored it and gone wandering off. And look at this. I mean, that looks like relatively good today. Like, I think this was on PS2. Really nice looking game. Who placed that lever there? Who thought, like, okay, well, we need a lever so we can easily access this. He's like, where should we put the lever? Just out of arm's reach, I reckon, would be a good place to put it. Can I not grab onto that? Surely not. Surely I can. Am I just doing this wrong? There's no way that, like, I don't know. Oh, do I have to get a box then to pull it? That's ridiculous. I said in my other video about how this level seems plausible if it wasn't in a game, but that definitely doesn't. Oh no! So much for gently shimmying my way down, just charge straight down. This wall is so bright. Hope I'm not blinding you. Okay, well that's where I've got to get to. But how do I get there? There's no way I can get across there, is there? Oh, I'd have to go along. Here we go. Okay, I got it. It's alright. I've played Uncharted. I know what I'm doing here. I've played Tomb Raider. Right, can I make that? And I don't. Oh, yeah, up. I'm such an idiot. See, this is what I mean about, like, when I'm doing commentary, I miss the completely obvious thing. I was trying to jump straight across there. I didn't see this bit. Now, this is where I'm scared that I'm going to press the wrong button. Because here, on a game like Uncharted, if you press just the wrong button, you'll normally just drop to a wrong ledge or just won't move. Here, I press the wrong button, I drop off, I fall, and I die. There's no leniency. Which is fine. It's just, you've got to be very careful and you've got to completely understand what every single button press is going to do, and I still have a certain amount of uncertainty. If you haven't seen the first videos, let me just remind you that I'm pressing triangle to jump. Triangle to jump? Which game has triangle to jump? I think maybe Skyrim and Oblivion has triangle to jump. So apart from that, who has triangle to jump? It's just not natural. Like, it feels weird. Okay, here we go. Alright, so I'm guessing this is a box I can knock down, and then I can go and grab the lever. And oh, look, there's a sofa up here, so it looks like I'm going to be able to save shortly. I should think there's a save point earlier, which I missed. Oh, no, there's finger pops coming. Yordo, are you okay? Oh, no, they're already pulling her down. Is she down there? Where is she? Oh, she's here. I thought that was her down. Okay, right, let's do it. Everybody was kung fu fighting. Those cats were fast as lightning. In fact, was a little bit frightening. They fought with expert timing. I'm sorry. I'll stop singing. Funky China Man from Funky China Town. No, sorry, seriously, I'm done. Okay, I will promise you now, I'm never going to sing again during this Let's Play. You're safe. You don't have to stop watching right now. These guys are just relentless. They don't learn. You can't beat a stick. No matter how powerful and strong, no matter if you can fly and use mystical powers, you can't beat hitting someone with a stick. It's the ultimate weapon. I don't even know if I am ever going to get another weapon. It would be nice to get some sort of sword or something just to make cleaning these enemies up a little bit easier. Oh, no, I don't want to go up there yet. Actually, no, wait. Oops, sorry, love. Didn't mean to do that. I'm going to go up here and just save first before I go and pull that lever, because I can't be bothered to go and do half the game again, so I don't think I've saved in quite a while. So let's go down onto my sofa and save my progress. I think in the future, they're going to cover up all of the gamey side of things like a lot more than they do. I think they've started it now, like saving and just unrealistic stuff, like with the settings and that. I think the more you can cover that up, the better. Because like, it'll make it more immersive. Right, so I reckon pulling that lever is going to extend this out somehow, and I'm going to be able to get across. Okay, Yorda, you got a choice. You can stay there or you can come with me. To be honest, I really don't care. Actually, don't come with me just in case something attacks you. I'd rather have you by my side. I mean, there are times when she can, like, seem like a nuisance babysitting her, but compared to some other games in which I play doing escort missions and stuff, like, it's far less painful than that. Alright, let's see if I was right. Let's see if this bridge extends. Oh no, what am I doing? Oh no, a chain drops down. Looks like there's more to the puzzle than I first thought. I don't even know where that chain went down from. I'm gonna go catch up with Yorda anyway and see how she's doing. I love that pulling box animation. It just makes me laugh somehow. It just seems really like comic booky, like really like just how quick and over the top it is. Right, Yordi, what's the dealio? What's going on here? Are you okay? You alright? Yeah, she's okay. Right, how do I get to that chain then? Is it down here somewhere? Looks like I'm going to have to get my shimmy on again. Oh! Jesus. I'm the least elegant at this game ever. It's like, okay, let's just gently lower myself down. Nope, just plunge off the edge. I mean, I know I've got stuck a few times in this game, but every time I've found out the solution, I've never felt at all cheated. I feel like every time that I have got stuck, it's due to my own lack of ability rather than, like, the game being really obscure. But saying that, right here, how am I going to get to that chain? The chain seems to be, like, on the other side of where I'm trying to get to. Like, I thought I'd need to use the chain to get over there, but I've got to get over there to be able to use the chain. Right, let's go back up and have a look around. Yorda, you were right there. She's just there, just watching me. Anytime you feel the urge, feel free to give me a hand. Feel free for you to maybe work out the solution to one of these puzzles, you know? It doesn't have to always be me doing the work. He's very skinny as well. I feel like he should put some weight on. I wonder the last time he ate. Okay, well, the camera angle. Oh, here we go. I can shimmy around here. Yorda! Come stay where I can see you. Do you need a hand getting up? Do you need a hand? No, she's okay. She's capable. The first time in her life, she's capable of doing something. Here we go. Are you joining me? You're gonna stay there. I don't think she can do this. Surely not. Ooh. He's got a very firm grip. It's pretty impressive. Now what? If I drop, I'm going to die, aren't I? Like, can I grab onto that ledge so I can go around there? I've saved very recently, so... Okay, I did die, but I've worked out where I am, because you know the part which I got stuck on, like, in the end of the last video? So directly down from me is the room on the opposite side of there. Is there no reason to be able to shimmy across there? Or can I just follow this one across? Is that why that pillar's destroyed? Can I just carry on? I think I can. I think I've just been completely stupid. It's just so bright. I would turn the brightness down, but I know I'm going to remember to turn it back up, and I'm going to go back to, like, a cave section somewhere, and you're not going to be able to see anything. I can fix it a certain amount in colour correction, but, like, I would have lost a few pixels. And no one likes to lose a pixel. Keep a close eye on them. Okay, now I can... Okay, so I need to get her across here to open those penguins. So I just need to find a way of extending that bridge. So hopefully I'm going to... Whoa, hopefully I'm not going to die. Oh, where did the chain go? I swear there was a chain down here. Ah, I know what's happened. Bloody hell. Okay, I'm going to skip ahead. Because I died and didn't do that save, I haven't pulled that lever anymore. So yeah, I'm just going to skip ahead quickly now. Okay, sorry about that. I just thought I'd skip ahead a bit. Oh no, what's going on? I know this thing is... Oh, don't go take her. I'm all the way over here. I've got to go all the way back again. Oh, what the hell? was that because I left it for too long? What's going on? All I did was I went back to that lever which I just pulled a second ago, and I pulled it again because I died. I revert back to an old save where I hadn't pulled the lever, and have I left her like away too long, or does that always happen anyway? Are they even close to her? I think that actually, I don't actually think there's any danger. Okay. I think we're alright. They don't seem to be doing much. I think they're just having a little party in the corner of that room there, so I don't want to intrude. I'm just going to leave them to it, and I'm going to carry on as I was. I think that's a bit of a false alarm. I just know that I'm going to have to fight them when I get down there. Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, my God. Oh, alright. Don't make it too dramatic. Get on the chain. Get on the chain. Don't go around. That's it. Yeah, you got it? There we go. And down you go. Am I going to the bottom? Oh, have I got to swing into there? I'm not going to enjoy this. I'm going to be too scared. I'm going to miss. After having to go back and do that whole bit again. I don't want to do it all over again. Come on, build up your momentum. Big swings, big strokes. And go. Nicely done. Is this where those things are? Yeah, they are. I'm not worried so much because Yorda's not here. Like, I hope she is alright, but I'm not protecting anyone. I can just go mental and just lay into them without having to worry about her. Which makes a nice change. Don't get up. I so do hope that they do finish making The Last Guardian. You do have to look at some of the trailers for it. If it looks as good as the trailers make it out, I think it would be fantastic. They say that it's going to be kind of like a combination of Ico and Shadow of the Colossus. And in the video, you just see like a boy, and there's like a big... It's kind of like a dragon, dog, bird thing. It looks a bit like Falcor from the Neverending Story. And it's like a big, massive thing. And like you just know plain that you're going to fall in love with it. Do I push these down? I'm not sure what's that doing, because that's the bit I was in earlier when I was actually looking for a box and I was actually trying to jump up here, so hopefully that will help me a little bit later on, but at the moment I'm just trying to get Yorda down here. Maybe I do have to jump through there. Doesn't seem to be anywhere else I've got to go, so I guess I do have to go through there. At least because I've pushed blocks down, I know I'm going to be able to get back up. Right, now what then? I can't remember how I got up to where she was. I don't know what I've gained by having these two blocks here. I don't know how this has helped me. So I'm basically... I don't want to go all the way back up there and see if I've missed something. Okay, there's a chain there. How do I get to there? Do I go around here? Maybe? Ah, okay, I can play... Lucky I didn't go all the way back up to her and then be like, now what? Seems I've got to use one of these boxes and I can climb up there. I don't know why I need two boxes, though. I feel like they'd only place two boxes if I needed them. So I can go around the edge. Right, one box at a time. Let's not rush this. So, I've no idea where this is going to let me end up when I climb up that chain, but I guess there's only one way to find out. A lot of people always praise this game for the experience of it and just the art of it. A lot of people just say, like, oh, it's just, like, a really good arty game. Like, whenever people talk about it, that's just all they talk about, like, the fact that it's a really pretty game, basically, and like a good experience, and the fact that it's different. But I think it's well designed anyway, ignoring the fact that it's unique and pretty and stuff. I think it's just a well designed game in terms of the gameplay. I think it's got good puzzles. I think it does enough to kind of explain what you need to do and then lets you work it out. And I like the fact that it's like this one big area, and like, I know that if I wanted, I could backtrack pretty much towards the beginning of the game, and it lets you work things out and, like, suggest things. I think, just in terms of level design and the puzzles and stuff, I think it's just a well-designed game, despite the fact that it is everything else that it is. It's a really good-looking game, and it's unique and stuff. Right, it looks like I'm not going to get much momentum swinging from that low. Let's move down a little bit, shall we? Oh. I didn't want to go down quite as low as that. It didn't seem to do things by half, so I pressed down and you just sort of dive to the bottom of the chain. Right. There looks like a good medium. Right, get your swing on. Still makes me love the fact that he just completely swings through the middle of the chain. Am I going to make that? Well, let's find out. Ooh, easy. He looked like smashed his chest and oh, I think I've hurt him. You alright? You alright down there? What's he doing? What are you doing, boy? Get up. Okay, now this lever should extend the bridge. There. Oh, she's already on it. Oh, no, and there's thingies down there. Why does it always have the thingies come there when I'm miles away? Let me move. Get on the chain. Get down, get down, get down. Down, 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 down. Get off, get off, get off. Got her. I've got her. Oh, no, she's over there. I'm coming, I'm coming, I'm coming, Yoda. Hang on, fight, fight, fight. And she's safe. Once again, another close call. Right, I can't even take her over to that corner. I was going to take her to that corner. I was like, oh, there's another one there. Right, you stay here. Come on, guys, bring it on. I'm ready for you. What are you doing? What are you staying over there for? Oh, there are all these annoying ones that, like, go in the wall. Oh, this one isn't. This is one of these ones. I'm learning the different enemy types, even though they all kind of look the same. Oh, I can see you. What are you trying to do? Yeah, you get out of it. This seems to be the main foe, and these ones are just... I think these ones all die in, like, pretty much one hit, but they're just really awkward to hit. I think I can only hit them when they're on the wall as well, actually. I know, I can hit them when they're on the floor. Yeah, they'll just die in one hit. These are the only ones that I really want to worry about too much. The only problem is, like, while laying into one of these massive ones, when the little ones could sneak up behind and yoink my girl, which is never a good thing. Right, are we done? All done? All good. All right, Yoda, you're up. Do your thingy my pops. Whenever you're ready. Take your time. I mean, it's not like we're all waiting for you. Oh, come on. There we go. Just needed to touch her hand slightly. And we're through. Right, where are we now? Is this a new area? Oh, this is where I was earlier. I remember this. Remember lighting my torch on one of them and I got a bomb and blew some stuff up. So this is what I like. I love it when... Oh, sorry, I'm completely forgetting about Yoda here. I like when everything's all kind of connected together and you go in one area, then you're like above a different area, and then you can see where you've got to get to, but you can't get there yet, and then later on you work out what you've got to do. I love all that sort of stuff, all the intertwined kind of levels. It's kind of what I tried doing on Minecraft with my house, having lots of different passageways and things leading from one area to another area, and it all kind of joined up, but not like as a grid or a straight line or anything, all kind of all over the place. Okay, well, there's a ladder back there which I saw, but first I'm going to go over this way, over this incredibly bright bridge, and see what's over here. Or can I go all the way around? Or is this a dead end? No, I can go around. Okay, well, I'm gonna go up that ladder first then before I trek all the way over there and then have to go back. Because that is kind of miles away. So bright. If only I was bright. Might struggle a little bit less in this game. Ooh, I like this. I like the design work here. Shame I can't do anything there. Okay, is that... I bet what's going to happen is, yeah, this door's locked. I'm going to trek all the way across that bridge into that building. It's going to be a big empty room with just one lever in the middle of the room. I'm going to pull it and that door's going to open. I'm going to have to walk all the way back. But that's what's going to happen. I'm sure it won't be quite like that, but something along those lines. Be embarrassing if my guy's got sweaty hands. The girl will be like, ew, get off. What I think should happen now is like some music to start playing. I'm scared someone's gonna like, I keep thinking someone's gonna jump out from that ravine like a big monster or something, then I remember what game I'm playing. Like this is a good moment for where like automatic could randomly just start playing. Music could just start playing, sorry. Just start going do 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 do, crossing the bridge with a girl by my side. That's what should happen there. Oh no! I promised him like my video, which I'll never sing again. And I just did. Well, that was a more dramatic camera angle to show it. Well, she's bloody charging ahead. She's leading the way for once. That's never happened before. Why? What is it? What's in here? Okay. Oh, a sword! Oh, can I have the sword, please? Please, can I have the sword? Please, can I have the sword? I want it instead of my stick. Right, there's a sofa there, and I really want to save. There's a few sticks down there on the floor, but I don't care about sticks. I'm ready for my upgrade. From sticks to sharpened steel. En toi? En toi? Oh, here we go. Why did it not let me save, and then these things start coming out, yeah? Why did they have to come out, then I get to save? Because if I die now, I'm going to walk all over that bridge again. Oh, I think I just knocked the order over as well. These guys take so long, like these massive, like, brutes. These are the tanks. Get rid of you. You can bugger off. Oh, is that it? Is that them all done? Okay, that's okay. That's what the combat should be like. A bit of a nuisance. You get rid of them, then you can move on. Not like a 5-minute task you have to deal with. Anyway, I think this is a good point to end the video now, as I just have a little quick rest on my sofa. So I want to thank you very much for joining me on this video. I have a link in the description to part number 8 of this Let's Play. But cheers for watching, and I will see you later.